Erinnert ihr euch noch an diese Szene?
Hä? Das geht. Soll ich mal bitte Force Fernsehen? Vielleicht müssen wir was auslösen. Nein, da ist nichts.
Okay.
Da kann man den. Oh, dann kannst du den Fernsehen ausmachen, anmachen, am Fernsehen machen.
Oh Gott. Okay. Kommt jetzt rein. Oh oh. Oh oh. Oh oh.
Geh doch hin! Ich will das doch sehen!
Ach so! Scheiße!
Du nicht!
Geh weg!
Okay, das war's. Boah, jetzt hab ich mich aber so erschreckt!
Soll ich jetzt irgendwas respawnen? Meistens sind ja nach den Schockern. Halt den auf.
Oder an diese Szene.
Okay, nochmal da mal kurz gucken. What? Was war das denn gerade? Hast du es gesehen? Einmal so ein Aufheller?
Ja, klar habe ich das gesehen.
Klar habe ich das gesehen.
Ich bin noch nicht blind.
Du. Wo ist denn die Tür?
Hä?
Oh nö. Die Tür ist weg.
Da war wieder. Der Raum wird enger.
What? Oh, fuck!
Genau, es geht um Pinewood Drive. Pinewood Drive haben wir im Livestream vor, weiß nicht wie vielen Jahren, gezeigt. Pinewood Drive wurde von VES Games entwickelt und war ein sehr schönes Horrorspiel mit kleinen Rätseln und einer schönen Story. Wir haben es sehr genossen, das Spiel. Und jetzt ist nämlich die Frage für euch nämlich gestellt und für uns natürlich auch. Es soll ein Pinewood Drive 2, ein Pinewood Drive Rising Storm, so nennt man es, rauskommen. Das gibt es im Moment auf Kickstarter. Und dieses Video hier zeigt ein kleines Infovideo von André Bürger, den ja, Chefentwickler von VES Games, glaube ich, ist das sogar, wie die ein bisschen Pinewood Drive Rising Storm vorstellen. Und ich werde natürlich in der Beschreibung auch den Link zum Kickstarter-Projekt reinstellen, denn es ist sehr wichtig, dass ihr da auf jeden Fall die Entwickler ein bisschen unterstützt, denn Pinewood Drive war ein sehr gutes Spiel, ich kann es nur jedem empfehlen. Und schaut euch einfach das Video an, viel Spaß dabei.
Hi, my name is André. I'm the lead developer from Pinewood Drive 1 and also the game Passing Pinewood Forest. And now for Pinewood Drive Rising Storm, I'm also the main responsible lead developer. Pinewood Drive 1 was a very successful game later on. And a lot of people asked us for a sequel of the game and wanted to know more about the background story of the old mansion. And that's one of the reasons we want to tell more about the background stories, about everything what's behind the scene. The basic gameplay will be close to the first one, so we have again a very atmospheric horror game. We have more possibilities now to interact with objects in the house, explore much more details. There are also no defendable enemies in the game, so everything will be more focuses on pure atmospheric horror again. The only way is exploring and yeah, trying to avoid evil things. The core team of the game will be the same like in Pinewood Drive 1, so we have me again for the main programming, let's say. We have Jan again for the sound effects and the music, but one special guy is coming to us now is Michael Czerczopan, who is the main author for the whole story, for the dialogues. That's the biggest change in this project.
Hi, my name is Michael. I'm the author of Pinewood Drive 2. I will be responsible for all the dialogue and all the scenario stuff that's happening in the game. And I'm a freelancer in the video game industry, so I worked on several games before, and I'm basically here to scare you. The main protagonist of the game will be Lisa. This is an everyday person like you and me. She cannot fight, she got no special combat skills, she is not a super soldier or something. And she's haunted by dark images of the past that are somehow connected to the dark mansion in Pinewood Drive. So she is going there to find out the truth. Rising Storm will connect perfectly to the first game, so people who played the first game were left with a few questions about the mansion, why it is haunted and why it is so dark, and we will deliver all these answers in the second game, and we'll tell much more about the environment. For example, the lighthouse that's out in the ocean and the forest that's right in front of the mansion. All these background information we will be added to the second game and build a much richer universe, horror universe, to explore.
Like in Pinewood Drive 1, we will also try again to add special features to the game that might appear in your real world and not only behind the monitor. We are permanently tracking your mouse and keyboard inputs, and we try to detect changes in sudden moments. For example, if you walk down the street, something happens behind you and you suddenly stop, the game will notice that you showed any reaction to the game.
In terms of the scare tactics and how we try to create fear to the player, you don't have to worry about nonsense like zombies and monsters and other stuff that are not true to the Pinewood Drive universe. Instead, we are trying to play with your imagination. What is lurking in the dark? What was that weird sound at the end of the hallway? It'll be all about the dark and haunting atmosphere. We try to play with your imagination, try to trick you a bit, and do things that lie beyond your negative space.
After the success of Pinewood Drive 1, we are also sure that Pinewood Drive Rising Storm will be successful, but this time we want to add more settings to the game. We want to visit more locations. We want to have more detailed graphics and a much more intense storyline and much more storytelling in the whole game. And this is the reason why we need more development time for the whole production, and we need more budget to realize everything we want to do. And this is the main reason for us to go to Kickstarter.